Assalamualaikum, dear students. Today we are going to do the uses of may and might. Now these two modal verbs are very important and they are often thought of related. We think that might is the past tense of may and may is the present tense of might. But we don't know in which sentence should we use may and when to use might and what is the difference between may and might. Now this lecture would make you clear about the use of these two modal verbs, about the sense which they would be conveyed in a sentence. The lecture is going to make you understand reading comprehension passage better. It will help you attempt your translation passages better. It will help you do your correction of sentences and exercises better. It will help you in your speech as well, when you're speaking as well. Now, what are the uses of may? The first use of may is about expressing the possible. Now, whatever is possible, whatever is factual, or whatever could be factual. To express all these three things, we use may, the modal verb may. Now let's see how. Here is the example. Here are a few examples. He may lose his job. Now, who may lose his job? He may lose his job. Now, it is possible. The situation is such that there is a possibility that he may lose his job. Maybe because of the economic condition of the country, maybe the economic condition of the economic crisis in which his company has found himself. But there is a possibility that this person, he may lose his job. Then we may go on vacation. So there's a probability, there's a possibility that we'll go on vacation. I may have dessert after dinner. So there's a possibility that you may take some sweet dish after dinner. So all these three examples, they are telling us about something which is possible or factual, or it could become factual, it could become a fact. In the sentences where we want to communicate possibility, we use may. Then may is used in prayers. And here's a famous example. May you live long. May you pass an exams. Okay? Then might. What is might? The common, the most popular answer, and again, obviously the right one is might is the past tense of may. Well, might is definitely a past tense of may. In most confusing situations, you can easily make the correct choice by remembering this fact that may is the present, is used in the present tense. And might is used in a past tense. For example, he might have called earlier, but I was not at home. Okay, it's past tense. The criminal might not have been caught had you not sounded the alarm. Past tense. I may go to the movies tonight. Present. Okay, so might is the past tense of may. It is used instead of may in the past tense where you want to express possibility or you want to express some fact or some fact which could be possible. Okay, so might is the past tense of may, and you can determine the tense of your sentence by thinking whether it's present tense or a past tense, and after determining the tense of your sentence, the time of your sentence, you can easily choose between may and might. If it is present tense, then may will be used. If you are talking about present, then it is may which will be used in a sentence to show possibility to express some fact or to express something that would be factual. But if it is in the past tense, then the past form of this modal verb may, might would be used. Now there are grammarians who say that may and might are individual entities, they are not related, but definitely they are related as past and present, just like can is related to could, just like will is related to would, shall is related to should. That is, we use these modal verbs, might, should, would, could, when in the sentences where we want to convey the sense of may, shall, will, can in the past. Got it? May is the past present tense of might, and might is the past tense of may. And may is used to express something which is possible, something which is actual, or something that would be virtual. And as I told you, here's the example. He may lose his job, or he may go on vacation. I may have dessert after dinner. Okay? Or in present tense, like may you live long. I hope you have understood this use of may, and then might is used in the past tense. Like he might have called earlier, but I was not home. The gremlin might not have been caught had you not sounded the alarm. That is, if you had not sounded the alarm, the gremlin might not have been caught. Pakrana jata, see, the possibility has been discussed over here. Pakrana jata, agar tum alarm na bajata. He might have called earlier, but I was not at home. Wo jaldi bhi aa sakta tha, lekin main ghar par nahi tha. I may go to the movies tonight. Aaj main raat ko shayad movie dekhne chala jaunga. Something that is possible, that is factual, or could be factual, is expressed by use of these two modal verbs, may and might. And you can easily see what is the tense of your sentence. If it is present tense and you want to use may or might, and there is a problem of selection, which to use. So feel confident, if it's present tense, you use may. And if it is past tense, then confidently use might. Okay? There is no big deal in it. Then, uses of might. Now, we have seen that first use of might is the past tense of may. There are other uses of might. Unlike may, might is used to express hypothetical, counterfactual, or remotely possible. So what were the uses of may? I want you to go back to the slide. What were the uses of may? May is used to express something possible, something factual, or something that would be factual. But what are the uses of might? Might is used to express what is hypothetical, which is assumed, what is not real, what is not, it is imaginary, which is not as much possible. Okay, hypothetical, which is imagined. Counterfactual, which is counter to the fact. Remotely possible, something jo ke bahut hi dur se possible ho, yani ke jo ke possible, so bahut hi nadir, bahut hi nadir. For example, if you hurry, you might get there on time, but you are not hurrying. Okay? You might get there on time. Sorry. If you hurry, you might get there on time. So, there is no guarantee that even if you hurry, you would reach there on time. There is a possibility, a rare possibility. If you do it quickly, then maybe you will reach time. But this may be very impossible. It is remotely possible. If the speaker has said, if you hurry, you may get there on time. That is giving us the possibility. If you do it quickly, then maybe you will reach there on time. So that is giving us the hope. You will reach there on time. But this sentence is telling us that the speaker is not hopeful that even if the person would do hurry, you would not reach on time at the desired place. If I had shown up on time, I might have kept my job. So So the person is regretting, and he is saying that if he had shown up on time, if he had arrived on time, he might have kept his job. There's a possibility that he would have kept his job. So it is which did not happen, and however, he's talking about something which is remotely possible. If I win the lottery, I might buy a Ferrari car. So if I win the lottery, the speaker is hopeful that he might buy a Ferrari, but this hopefulness is hypothetical. Yet he knows that he will not, it is remotely possible, that it is not possible. Hypothetical, this is hypothetical. If I had shown up on time, I might have kept my job. Okay, this is remotely possible. Hypothetical and remotely possible. Something, so the person might have kept his job if he had shown up on time. But now he is fired. He's no longer there on the job. There's a possibility, a very remote possibility that he would win the lottery. There are very, very rare chances that he would win the lottery. He said he might buy a Ferrari. He's not sure. It is not certain. Now, may and might both are used for seeking permission. May and might also be able to both be used in asking for permission. For example, you may have another piece of cake. May I go to the restroom? Might I ask when the movie starts? Might I ask for a favor? But students, there is question. What to use for asking permission? Since we can use both may or might, so which is better? Which is better? Which is more popular with the speaker's office language? So when asking for permission, may is much more common than might. While both of these words can be used to ask permission, but if you are not careful, they can lead to ambiguity. So mostly may or might are acceptable in asking permission. However, it is more appropriate, it is more desirable that you use may for seeking permission, because otherwise there could be a little ambiguity, there could be a little confusion. For example, if you were to ask the question, may I go to the movies tonight? And you have received a response. Now you want to tell your friend whether you are going to the movies tonight with him or not. So you want to be very much clear. So you will want to be clear when you go to tell your friends whether or not you received permission to go to the movies that night. You cannot, for example, so you would tell them, okay, I may not go to the movies tonight. What does it mean? When you say this, what do you mean? Do you mean to say I'm not allowed to go to the movies tonight? Or do you mean I might not go to the movies tonight? In situations like this, it's better to use might to avoid any confusion that might arise. I might not go to the movies tonight. Got it, you girls? Kya hua? The use of may or might in seeking permission should be made very carefully. It's a common practice that we use may in asking for permission. Now, if you asked your parents that may I go to the movies tonight, and they have responded you some way in yes or no, and you want to share that permission with your friends. Suppose you have been refused. Your parents have denied, they have refused to give you the permission. ticket and you tell your friend that I may not go to the movies tonight. Iska kya matlab? Ab iske two meanings aa rahe hain there. Two meanings of the same sentence. Number one is I'm not allowed to go to the movies tonight. ठीक है ना? Your parents have not allowed you to go to the movies. ठीक है ना? और दूसरा इसका मीनिंग क्या है? दूसरा मीनिंग ये है कि मुझे चांस नजर नहीं आ रहा, बहुत ही कम चांस है कि मैं जा सकूं. ठीक है ना? So, क्या करना चाहिए आपको? आप ये कहेंगे कि I may not go to the movies tonight. मुझे परमिशन नहीं मिली. ठीक है, ये आप ये कहना चाह रहे हैं कि आपके चांसेस कम कि परमिशन के अलावा आपको ठीक है आप क्या कहना चाह रहे हैं. ठीक है, जब आपने ये कहा कि आई मे नॉट गो टू द मूवीज, इसका क्या मतलब हुआ? इसका मतलब इट मीन्स that you have not been given the permission by your parents to go to the movies tonight. ठीक है ना? And when you say that I might not go to the movies tonight, उसका क्या मतलब है? इसका मतलब जो है वो यही है that is a possibility. This is what you suppose is a hypothetical situation that you might not go to the movies that you think that you might not be able to go to the movies. Right, if you notice that might deals with situations that are speculative or did not actually happen. That is hypothetical. There is may deal with situations that are possible or could be factual. An easy way to express or remember this difference is that might suggests a more possibility than does may. If something is far-fetched, you probably want to use might. You could say might is the thing for, might is for things that are mighty far-fetched. So when you say I might not go to the movies tonight, so it is your what about your probability, the possibility? Yeah, आप कहते हैं कि आई वांट टू गो टू द मूवीज टुनाइट, मतलब ये है कि आपको परमिशन दे बिकॉज़ यू हैड फाइल द डेट परमिशन. देन टू समराइज, माइट कैरीज विद इट लेस प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड अप्लाइज टू हाइपोथेटिकल assumed, imaginary, not real, counterfactual situations. Might is also the past tense of may. Whereas may applies to situations that are possible or could be possible. So when talking about something that is not happening, it can better to use might to avoid confusion with permissive favor. कन्फ्यूजन, ये जब एग्जाम्पल मूवीज के लिए थी, तो कन्फ्यूजन को खत्म करने के लिए आपने माइट यूज किया था. ठीक है, सो वहाँ पे क्या था कि आई मे नॉट गो टू द मूवीज टुनाइट, परमिशन नहीं मिली है. सो आप कहते हैं आई माइट नॉट गो टू द मूवीज टुनाइट, सो इसमें कोई और रीजन भी हो सकता है. देयर इज अ लेसर प्रोबेबिलिटी, देयर इज अ लेसर पॉसिबिलिटी दैट यू वुड गो विद योर फ्रेंड्स टू मूवीज दैट. ठीक है, सो द कंफ्यूजन इज रिमूव्ड विद द यूज ऑफ माइट इन सच सिचुएशन. सो व्हाट हैव यू गॉट from today's lecture, students, you have learned that may and might both are the words which show possibility, which are used to take permission, which are used to talk about some things or some fact. Yeah, but may it carries more probability. Might carries lesser probability. If we draw a times, a scale from 1 to 10, today will you place? May. Might could be over here, which has less power. Then may would come over here, where there is more probability of something happening. Okay? So might is used to express things, talk about things which are hypothetical, which are not factual, which are less probable. Whereas may is used for things which are probable, which are possible. Okay. And when we are talking about our chances of going to some place, we will use may if there are greater chance of going to a place or doing something. So when you talk in terms of chances, we will use may. But if there are lesser chances for visiting some place, we will use might. Got it? I hope you have understood today's lecture, and wish you all the best with your test assignment. And today's assignment of yours, English assignment, is to find out the use of word may and might from your grammar books, and read the examples given in which over there in your books. Thank you very much. All the best.